In this illustration, we'll study about normal forces and equilibrium of a ball. Here the figure shows a ball of mass 5 kg resting between two inclined planes A and B. Here you can see in the figure. And we are required to find the normal forces on ball by the two planes. Here in the situation, if we draw the free body diagram of ball, here you can see the ball will be experiencing its weight 5g in downward direction, and say this is the reference line for incline A, which is at an angle 30 degree, and this is the direction normal to the incline on which the ball is resting, so this angle will also be 30 degree. Now in this situation, one normal reaction will be acting on the ball due to the plane A, which is normal to it. Say this is N1, which is at an angle 30 degree to the vertical. And another normal reaction is acting on it due to this plane, which is in this direction. Say this is N2, which is at an angle 45 degree with the vertical, because this angle is 45. So this angle we can write as 15 degree. So these are the only forces acting on the ball, and the ball is in equilibrium. So here I can write, for equilibrium of ball, if we balance the forces, here you can see in horizontal direction, to write the forces only the horizontal component of N2. So this can be written as N2 sine 45 degree. That should be equals to N1 sine 30 degree, that is the force acting on the ball toward left due to the normal reaction N1. So this will give us N2 by root 2 is equals to N1 by 2, or this will give us N1 is equals to root 2 N2, say this is our first equation. And another equation in vertical direction we can write, that is N1 cos 30 degree is balancing the downward forces, which is 5g plus n2 cos 45 degree. And on substituting the trigonometric ratios, this will give us n1 root 3 by 2 is equals to 5g plus n2 by root 2, that is our equation 2. If we continue over here, we can write from equations 1 and 2, you can see here, the value of N1 is given as root 2 N2. We can substitute the value of N2 over here, and we can simplify this, which will give us N1 root 3 by 2 is equals to 5G plus the value of N2 we can write as N1 by root 2. So this will become N1 by 2. So on simplifying, we are getting N1 multiplied by root 3 minus 1 by 2 is equals to 5g, can be written as 50. This implies the value of n1 we are getting is 100 by root 3 minus 1. This is the normal reaction on ball due to incline A. And now from equation 1 we can write the value of n2 is n1 by root 2. So this is n1 by root 2. So this can be written as 50 root 2 by root 3 minus 1. So these are the value of normal reactions acting on the ball due to inclined planes A and B. That will be the result of this problem.